Hello everyone, welcome to the session on cybersecurity. So in this session we are going to look at another technique called buffer overflow. Okay, so this is also a technique related to the logic of the application. So in buffer overflow, it is dependent on a vulnerability where the process stores data in a buffer outside its own memory. Okay, so you can consider buffer as an array, and it is normal in programs to store data in arrays or buffers. And whenever you are using arrays or buffers in a program, in languages like C, where there is no bounds checking, you should be careful. Otherwise, buffer overflow attacks can be possible. Okay, so in this attack, the attacker will provide extra data while giving input, or in some other way, they will give extra data, that is malicious data, which will override the data in adjacent memory areas. In the next coming few slides, we will see an example of this memory locations, etc. And when giving such extra data, which will override adjacent memory locations, that will result in memory errors, incorrect results, as well as program crash. Okay, so which is like a denial of service attack. So there are two types. One is stack-based buffer overflow and heap-based buffer overflow. So this is the process image for every process running on your system. In the random access memory, that is RAM, the process image will be created. Okay, so every process will have text segment, data segment, heap area where data will be stored, runtime data, and you will have a stack where function related data will be stored. And on top of stack, you have a kernel, which belongs to the operating system. So this is the process image from here to here. Okay, so let's consider an example for buffer overflow, and this is for stack based buffer overflow. Consider this C code program, which is written in C. So here is a function called func, which is accepting a parameter. So it is basically a string pointer to a string where I will give the data here. Okay, so this will go to the parameter name, and in the inside the function we are creating a character array which is named buff. So this is our buffer of size 100, and whatever data I am giving here, I am copying it into buffer. Okay, buffer of buff array, and finally I am printing that data. For example, if I give Ramesh here, it will print welcome Ramesh. So this is a simple program, looks simple. Okay, so how can this program be used for performing buffer overflow is, before going to that, let's look at the process image. You can see on the right hand side, so here is the stack from here to here. You can think of the bottom locations like you have heap, text segment, data segment. Don't worry about that. So consider the stack. So here, this memory is for name. Okay, and this is the return address, function return address. So the function is called here. So the address of this location will be stored here. And this is a base pointer which is related to the function, and here is the buffer array. So from here to here, this is your buffer array. Okay, now see here. So when the program is executed normally, you will execute like this. I think this is Linux or Unix based system. So we will run the C programs like this, dot slash program name followed by the data. So this data goes into here, and from here it goes into name, and from name it is stored into buffer. Okay, and the output is this welcome metadata. Now see here, instead of giving text like metadata etc., they are giving code like this. Okay, so by using this code, what will happen is this will be given as input. Okay, 100 number of yes. So here this is hexadecimal notation. Okay, slash x 41 means a, and then you are printing 4 b's, which is 42 42 42, and you are printing and you are giving 4 c's, 43 43 43. And now see here, the size of buffer a is only 100, but here you are giving 100 a's followed by 4 b's and 4 c's. Now what happens? So actually this is the size of buffer. Now since you are giving BBB, CCC also extra data, it will start overwriting this data. Okay, so that's why you can see here base pointer address location is being overwritten. Okay, and it will be stored like this. So these are the 100 characters, AAA, 4 B's and 4 C's. So your base pointer address location is gone, and the second one is return address is also overwritten with CCCC. So that's why you are getting this segmentation fault error. Okay, right. And now instead of giving the normal input like AAA, BBB, CCC, instead of that you will give something called shell code. Okay, so here you have shell code. This is a specifically or crafted code or malicious code, you can say. So it includes shell code along with some characters like E repeated multiple times. So once this shell code is executed, what happens is, as you can see here, you got the root access and a shell is created where you can execute commands like a administrator. You can create files, view files, modify files, you can delete files, and you can shut down the system. So this is how buffer overflow can be used to exploit the weakness in code. Okay, so that is why we are writing programs in languages like C, where there is no bounce checking, we have to be very careful. Otherwise, attackers can use buffer overflow attacks. So, and finally, let's see how to prevent the buffer overflow attacks. So you have to do assessment of your code, that is proper testing should be done. And if possible, you can disable the stack execution, and you can use specialized compiler tools for checking the various code paths, etc. And you can do dynamic runtime checks, which can be helpful to prevent heap-based overflow. And you can use third-party tools for detecting buffer overflow attacks. So that's it about buffer overflow attack.